Hello, Mike again, second video. I've had a request for some more information on how I work out of my advanced RV, Mayflower. And so following up on that request, I thought I would combine some of my technology for business, which I try to limit when I'm out in Mayflower, and entertainment. They kind of go together. The equipment does. So coming on in, again, we have the sofa bed configuration. Some people have twin beds and bunk beds and all kinds of unique recliners and beds that do all kinds of fancy things. So anyway, sitting here at my TV came with the order that we placed with Advanced RV. And so right now I'm on a computer going to satellite. We have satellite TV coverage, which we're in Colorado right now. This works very good for us as we get remote. And as you can hear, it's going through the system up here that is a Pioneer head unit. Also, if you want to silence it, you can turn it off. Further, you can go back, and I have an iPod back here behind the TV. And you can listen to music. And even though we're remote, there is an FM station out here, so pretty loud there. There's mute. But going back to the TV setting, auxiliary input gives us quite a bit of our audio through the different sources on auxiliary. Also have an old retired iPhone that I'm using for showing the time at night. Behind the TV, we have some equipment here. Just name them off for you. I have a hard drive for backing up my Macintosh computer. It's a Mini Mac or Mac Mini. I have plugged into one of the USB ports the ability to read different formats of video cards. SD and CD are the main formats I'm interested in. Then I have a Blu-ray player here. I can play DVD, CD, and I can play Blu-ray movies. I can also record data to any of those formats. This originally came over here where you see on the wall some Velcro. Apple TV was there. Apple TV and this computer have the same power cable and the same HDMI into the TV for sound and video. So it was pretty easy to take the Apple TV out and put the computer in. Also have a camera for this if I need a video conference through Skype or I suppose other products. This is the really the heart of the network. It's the Wi-Fi Ranger. And as you can see, I have several green lights running and a red light. And the red light signifying that up on the roof of the van, there's another unit that works with the Wi-Fi Ranger. It's the Sky version. And it allows me to hit my Wi-Fi out the window and into my house. So that's where my connectivity to the internet's coming to from right now. So we also have power cords, USB, and a USB converter for Apple products such as iPhone and iPads. We do a lot of charging back here. Also, Advanced RV places, you can't see it, but in our nightstand back here, there's charging for iPhones, Androids, anything that's USB charging. So that's the back of it. Coming back to the front, we have the satellite currently running. I'm not in an area where I can get TV signals, but you do have a TV antenna input. And on the wall here, there's a switch for AB switch. So you have a connection outside the van. If you have a cable hookup at your campsite, you switch that to cable, and it'll bring cable in to the TV antenna input. I'm currently on satellite. Skipping on down, I'm at a HDMI input where my says Apple TV from the original, but I have the computer running here now. I use a wireless Bluetooth keyboard and pad, trackpad, and it allows me to look at my email here that I have currently running. This is my browser. This is the screen for my Wi-Fi Ranger, if you see up there in the upper left-hand corner. And the green shows that I'm hooked up to one of my Wi-Fi connections inside my house at 8.68 MIPS. And this would allow me to go in and look for a McDonald's or a library hookup or a neighbor who's not protecting their, here's an open Wi-Fi in the neighborhood, not very strong. Of course, it's a browser, so I can see what's going on at Advanced RV. Another passion of ours is Walt Disney World. So, browsing, email, and then for me, Windows 7. I run Windows 7 on a Macintosh, and I do that so I can get to my PC, go to my PC, into my office computer in Oklahoma, and do work from that computer directly in my Advanced RV. Also have calendar running, but you get the idea. You have options here to connect to the world personally or business-wise. So in a moment, we'll go up on the roof. I'll show you some of the equipment there. And entertainment wise, of course, if you're hooked up to the computer Wi-Fi network, you can reach out and pull in TV shows with Hulu and different software sites. Okay, let's say I'm not where I can have a Wi-Fi connection. I have my hotspot here. It's a Verizon, and it allows me to go through my cellular network if I'm in range and pick up my internet that way. Wi-Fi Ranger back here will pick this up as we go down the highway. Our iPhones, our iPads, our computers all relate to the network, not to this. So whatever I'm pulling in from my Wi-Fi Ranger, it's blind to my other technology. Now, sometimes my wife might want to be on TV doing things, so I have my Apple MacBook Pro that I can get onto, and it's hooked up to this network. My iPad, my iPhone, just about any kind of technology that'll network. And then I can print to the printer here if I need a hard copy. I can scan a document that needed my signature back to my computer and send it off to the recipient.
So let's go up on the roof, see what's up there.
One other thing before we go out. The satellite receiver is built in on this particular model, right above the TV. Instead of infrared remote, it's radio signal remote. So it doesn't bother it to have the door closed. The remote still works great. And the keyboard trackpad, I try to store it back in this area so it's easily accessible when I want to get on the internet. Okay, this is the top of the van. You can see all the equipment up here. It's pretty busy. One of our solar panels is here and another's up front. But this little black box at the very end of the van is the Wi-Fi Ranger Sky. And it's what helps you get out to other Wi-Fi systems outside the van and bring them in to give you connectivity. On up to, at the very front is a dome, and that's a satellite dish receiver. I'll move up there and show you that a little bit more. Okay, that's the satellite receiver for I use DirecTV satellite, because adding on another receiver that you saw inside is very economical to do. And there's the other view of the roof. Small antenna in front is a cell phone booster that we have, and that's the antenna for it. And in front of it, the little hump is part of the GPS navigation system antenna, and of course your radio antenna in front there. So I hope that helps you understand a little bit of how I do business out of the Mayflower, and also do some entertaining. Not everybody wants to go out into a beautiful area and watch TV all the time. Get out and hike and ride bikes and read books, different things. But that's what we do a lot, and have enjoyed sharing that with you. Hope that answers your questions.